The Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Abubakar Malami, on Wednesday defended his labeling of the just repatriated $311 million previously looted by the late head of state, General Sani Abacha, as Abacha assets. Malami came under criticism on Twitter between Monday and Tuesday for what commentators described as the minister's improper labeling of the proceeds of the looting perpetrated by the then maximum ruler. In a statement by his special assistant on media and publicity, Dr. Umar Gwandu, Malami said he deliberately referred to the funds as Abacha assets because it had been repatriated to Nigeria and qualified as federal government's asset. We are now joined by the executive chairman of Coalition Against Corrupt Leaders, CACOL, Comrade Dabo Adeniran. Good morning, Mr. Adeniran.
Good morning, my sister.
Now, the Attorney General of the Federation and Minister of Justice, Malami, came under heavy criticism for referring to, you know, the repatriated funds as Abacha assets because it had been repatriated to Nigeria, according to him, and qualified as federal government assets. What's your thought on that?
Yeah, thank you very much. First, I need to make two corrections. My name is Debo, D-E-B-O.
I apologize for that.
The organization is now Center for Anti-Corruption and Open Leadership, CACOL.
Okay, noted. We apologize for that.
On Abacha loot, turn asset, it is clear that Mr. Malami doesn't seem to want to call a spade a spade, because we know that looting is stealing. Looting is taking assets that belong to everybody illegally for the use of those that are entrusted with the custody of that asset. As long as the asset has been taken without authorization of the National Assembly or the ruling entity, even when it was military regime, we still have Armed Forces Ruling Council that ought to have approved the movement of the money from Nigeria to anywhere it is being kept all this while. And because that was not clearly stated, that it was approved by the Armed Forces Ruling Council or whichever ruling council operated during Abacha regime, we believe that Abacha stole that money. However, when you look at the tranches that has been coming from that money since the time of Abacha to date, you will want to refer to it as a kind of foreign reserve, because it's like it has turned to foreign reserve. Since 1998, we've been repatriating Abacha loot, and it has been coming almost every other year. For example, 1998, about $750 million was repatriated. Some money was repatriated in year 2000, year 2002, year 2003, up to 2020 that we are in now. Last year, it was £211 million that we got back. So it's like the Abacha loot will never get to an end. This shows that it couldn't have been only Abacha that looted the money. And that is why in some quarters, it has been said that the death of Abacha should be investigated. And even from the look of things, it is not likely that Abacha alone, that is the former head of state, General Abacha, could have been the only one that is involved in the looting of the humongous amount of money that has turned out to be an asset to Nigeria now.
Right. All right, let's talk about, sorry, in the interest of time, let's talk about this still on the money. Do you feel the federal government has shown enough transparency in terms of information sharing and on the management of the looted funds, you know, putting in mind the ones that we had gotten before and even this $311 million that we got again?
In fact, most of the repatriated Abacha loot has not been invested on projects that could be said is in the best interest of Nigerian people over the years. It is just during the period of this administration that we see a replica of transparency. It is not that the project upon which the loot was invested has been completed and been serving the interests of Nigerian people, but because we have been told where the money should go. Now, if we don't follow the money, it will be our fault as a civil society organization and your fault as a media organization to do your due diligence on it to ensure that if the money is being misapplied or is allowed to be looted without trace, then we are to blame ourselves. Hitherto, Nigerians have been so complacent that all the successive governments will just tell us that they have gotten so much money, but we did not follow it up to know where the money disappeared to. So this time around, we will be expecting the second Niger Bridge. We'll be expecting the completion of Lagos-Ibadan Expressway. We'll be expecting the completion of this power project.
The Mambila project.
The Mambila project and one other project like that.
The Kano, now they have Kaduna stated Expressway.
It. We should follow it to ensure that the projects that have been stated, because the U.S. government actually insisted that they wanted to know how the money would be applied before they gave us the money, although they should not have that right.
Yeah. And you've just started my other question, which is the fact that the U.S. has even warned Nigeria that if we don't use the money where it's said to be used, that they are going to ask that the money be refunded. How proper is that even?
Well, they are undermining our sovereignty as a country. But it is not their fault. It is the fault of our maybe those who don't think well of Nigeria, who can be called illegitimate children of Nigeria, that looted our funds and laundered it to their own country. Because the money was taken to their own country without them requesting for it, they could use their own domestic laws to determine under what condition they want to repatriate the money. As a matter of fact, the UN and other international bodies should have sanctioned US and other Western countries that have been receiver of stolen goods from Africa. But that is not to be, because majority of members of the UN, especially in the Western part of the world, the Scandinavian countries and so many other countries like that, where the money is being kept in safe haven, are beneficiary of looting of Africa. And maybe they are doing that to perpetually underdevelop Africa so that we will not be able to compete with them with superpowers, economic power. Right, so this might be the reason why they have to give us conditions before they return the stolen goods, because the policeman of the world that UN is supposed to be, those who are supposed to be savior, they are not saving us in Africa. They want to reduce us into nothingness, into their own colony all over again. Maybe it is with their complicit that the looting actually took place in the first place. They are encouraging their slaves, those who have volunteered to relinquish their humanity, to steal government, to steal African wealth, you know, to the extent that it could render us impotent. They are stealing commonwealth of Africans so much that it's crippling our economy, it's crippling our technology, it's crippling our medical sector, and that is why many African leaders will have to engage or embark in medical tourism. And because these Western countries are enjoying it, the Americas are enjoying it, the Scandinavia, the Asian countries are enjoying it, they are not bothered about the sufferings that have pervaded African continent. And this is why Africans themselves, African leaders, should look inward. They should become retrospective and to ensure that every money that is budgeted for projects in Africa is spent on Africa. And Africans should develop their own economy to the extent that they will not be exporters of raw materials anymore. They will process their raw materials to finish goods so that Africa will be able to rely on Africa without relying on all of those people who have enslaved us before, and they are making all efforts to enslave us again. This is why we should not allow people like Abacha to come back again. Anybody that has any outer of doubt that this fellow has a pedigree of stealing, we should not allow them to lead us anymore. We should do everything possible to ostracize all the looters in our society. We should do everything possible.
Thank you very much, Mr. Adeniran.
Every money is applied for the best interest of Nigerian people.
Thank you so very much, Mr. Adeniran, for your time and your thoughts there.
It's my pleasure. Thank you very much.